All right, guys, so we're going to focus on another variation problem. So this one here in word problem form. So before we even get started, before I start elaborating or talking about anything, let's just read through this problem first, and then we'll discuss how to solve it. So here, this specific problem says the weight m of an object on the moon varies directly as its weight e on Earth. So the weight on the moon varies directly as the weight on Earth. So we're talking about direct variation here. And it says that a person who weighs 164.4 pounds on Earth weighs 27.4 pounds on the moon. How many pounds would a 252-pound person weigh on the moon? So when it comes to variation problems, it's first important to figure out what kind of variation problem are you talking about. Is it direct variation? Is it inverse variation? Is it variation with respect to a power? Or what situation do you have going on? Because that's very much going to make a difference on how you calculate how you solve the problem. Because there are a few different forms of equations when it comes to variation, and the kind of variation you have is going to let you know, hey, what formula do I need to use for this one? So for this particular problem, we're talking about direct variation. So direct variation normally looks something like this, x is equal to ky. But for this particular problem, we're going to plug in components dealing with this specific problem. We're going to talk about weight of a person on Earth in comparison to weight of a person on the moon. So it says the weight of m, an object on the moon, varies directly as the weight e of someone on Earth. So that's going to translate to, so our x is going to be m, weight on the moon, and that's going to vary directly to the weight of someone on Earth. So when it comes to variation problems, there are normally two-part problems. The first part is taking information that they gave you, typically in the beginning of your problem, and using that to calculate k, your constant of variation. This constant is going to remain the same for that situation, for that particular problem, and you're going to be able to use that in order to calculate other things. So we're going to start with the weight of someone on the moon varies directly of the weight of someone on Earth. And what we're going to do is we're going to take this second sentence over here and apply it to this problem. It says a person who weighs 164.4 pounds on Earth, so that's our E, so I'm going to plug that in for E, 164.4, but they weigh 27.4 pounds on the moon, so I'm going to plug that in for M. So we're going to plug in the weight of someone on Earth, plug in how much they would weigh on the moon, and what we're going to do is we're going to calculate for that k, that constant of variation. And then once we solve for k, we're then going to look at our end piece here, our last sentence here, to actually calculate what this problem is asking us to do. So I'm going to grab my calculator here so we can figure this out. So let's see, in order to solve this problem here, the only thing we need to do is divide both sides by 164.4. And when we do so, k is equal to, so let's see, 27.4 divided by 164.4. So I'm getting 0.1666666 and so on. That's our constant of variation. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use that, we're going to rewrite an equation, weight of someone on the moon varies directly of the weight of someone on Earth. Now we can actually plug in our constant of variation because we calculated that, we solved for it, we know exactly what that equals, but now we're going to apply it to the second piece of information. Our question says, how many pounds would a 252-pound person weigh on the moon? So we're calculating for M, which means that 252 pounds is the weight of them on Earth. So we're going to take this 0.1666666, we're going to multiply it by 252, and that's going to give us the weight of the person on the moon. I got 42 pounds. So if you weigh 252 pounds on Earth, you would weigh 42 pounds on the moon. And if you're curious, you can go ahead and plug in your weight. So just take this constant of variation, 0.1666666. So let's see, I'm going to go ahead and calculate mine. So 0.1666666. If I calculate that times my weight, I would weigh about 25 pounds on the moon. So all you would have to do is take 0.1666666 here, multiply it by how much you weigh, and then you would know exactly how much we weigh on the moon. So again, just keeping in mind, make sure that you're pulling the correct correct variation formula first. Always solve for K, and then use that K to plug and chug into the other problem, just depending on the given information that they gave you there.